Hey YouTube, time for my October Birchbox, which is very late, but it's not all my fault. It's like half my fault, half Birchbox's fault. We're just gonna share the blame, no big deal. And then Hurricane Sandy happened, so hello. I never lost power or anything, and my heart goes out to anyone who was affected by it negatively, anyone who is stuck without power, had anything ruined, lost a loved one, anything like that. This storm really, really spared us. Our trash cans didn't even move on our porch. Like, that's how nice it was. Not necessarily nice, but just we were spared. We didn't lose power or anything. So anyone who has been affected by the hurricane or the nor'easter or the storm, whatever the hell they decided to call it, they like downgraded it, but they were like, we didn't downgrade. I'm not even gonna get there. So anyways, anyone who was affected by it, my heart goes out to you. I'm really sorry. Sucks. Superstorms are awful. So enough about that, and now more about superficial stuff like makeup. Let's see. So I didn't get the goop box because I don't know if Birchbox didn't send me the email or I missed out on the email, but I wanted it. I got the transformation box, and honestly, this is probably one of the worst boxes I've ever received. It just was just kind of blah, and everything felt really small. It just didn't really feel necessarily worth it. I mean, we'll see when I do the chings and then add it all up if it ends up being kind of worth it, but I don't know. I felt like this box kind of sucked. And the first thing that they talk about on this card are the LA, see, I think LA Fresh, but maybe it's La Fresh, which seems like kind of a stupid name to me. I'm gonna go with LA Fresh, but I think it's La Fresh. Whatever. Acetone-free nail polish remover. These are these little pads. I think these are convenient if you're traveling. If you're going someplace, you're gonna need to be taking your nail polish off and reapplying, so a long vacation, maybe one that's 2 weeks or so. But for the most part, it's not something that I'm gonna, you know, sample right now and be like, ooh, I need to get these. I'm just gonna save these up for when I'm going on a vacation. And, you know, so that's kind of a not fun sample to get. I mean, it'll be convenient and I'll probably like appreciate it when the time comes when I need it. But as for right now, in terms of like finding something that I can sample right now, kind of a dud. And they say, feel free to change up your mani daily. That can't be good for your nails, is it? Is it okay for your nails to change your nail polish every day? Does anyone do that? That seems like a lot of effort. But anyway, so they say, feel free to change up your mani daily. These pads dissolve polish with a mix of botanicals and soothing aloe vera. 20 packets are $9.99, so essentially it is, what, 50 cents a packet? So this is worth pretty much a dollar. So cha-ching, add a dollar to the total of my Birchbox. I'm not even gonna get technical with the cents. I know it's pretty much not a dollar. It's maybe like 99.999999 cents. Whatever, who cares? Sprout Lip Balm Flight. That is the next thing. Oh yeah, so they are selling these things called like Lip Balm Flights. And you might know about flights, like beer flights. If you're at a place, you can try different kinds of beers. A Lip Balm Flight seems, I don't know, a little strange to me. This one just has organic cocoa butter, organic beeswax, and organic coconut oil. Those are the only ingredients in this. So that's nice to have like a super organic-y lip balm. But I mean, lip balms are a dime a dozen to me. I have probably, you know, 50 strewn across my apartment in all different kinds of bags. So I'm not really looking for the next big lip balm in my life. But they say, made in the heart of Brooklyn, these yummy balms are made with organic coconut butter to nourish dry lips. And 4 lip balms cost $18, so cha-ching, that is how much my lip balm was worth. And the next thing is this City Sunscreen Serum from Supergoop. So this was something that the Goop boxes got also. I have received a sample from this brand before, just from a Sephora order. I haven't tried it out, but I am looking for something that would be a good kind of sunscreeny serum to have underneath makeup. I haven't found something yet because the type of sunscreen that I typically want to use is the like more natural organic-y one. So it's the like white cast and it's a little bit thicker. So the fact that this has no oxybenzone, it's paraben-free and fragrance-free, I feel like this might actually be a win for me. This might be something that I would be interested in pursuing and actually purchasing for my day-to-day makeup wear. We'll see. I don't know because I haven't tried it yet, but I am very annoyed that the packets are just these two little foil packets because I think it's a really shitty way to try out skincare because for me at least, I end up opening it and then not using it all and then throwing away the packet because it's hard to like reseal the packet, like put it in a plastic bag or something and save it. The product ends up getting kind of hard and crusty. So I would have preferred to receive something in some sort of tube. So they say, Wear this award-winning brand's Silky SPF 30 Serum under your makeup for a weightless UV shield. A full size ranges from $20 to $42, so I'll just go off the small size when I create my calculations. And cha-ching, that is how much the two little foil packets that I received are worth. And then the last item is the only kind of makeup-y item, and it is the Mary Lou Manizer. Get it? Luminizer? Mary Lou Manizer? So the Mary Lou Manizer, this is from theBalm Cosmetics, and when I saw that this was my box online, besides the initial disappointment, I thought to myself, okay, well this could be a good thing because they're probably giving me a full-size version of this. And it's not, it's very small. It's about an eyeshadow size. It's a nice kind of shimmery champagne color. So I was a little disappointed. I really thought that this was going to be full size, and then I was like, okay, well, I'm not very upset about not getting the Goop box, but now I kind of am. It's convenient. You know, it's a highlighter I can take with me and use. Here, let's use it a little bit. I mean, it's pretty, but it's just, it would have been nice to get it full size. So this is probably the only product in here that I'm like super stoked about. The Supergoop, I'm curious about. We'll see if I like it or not. And then the last item, I was just kind of like, ugh, I hate when they do this, but they gave me some food. And this is the Luna Fiber Bar. Actually, I do need to have more fiber, so maybe I should eat this. It is chocolate raspberry, soft baked fruit filled bar. Overall, I don't like getting any sort of food lifestyle extras. And they say, keep these yummy fiber packed bars on hand at all time. A pack of 15 is $14.95, so essentially this is like worth a dollar. So cha-ching, add that to the Birchbox total, and there you have it. Here is the running total of the value of the Birchbox on the whole. I don't know what it is yet because I haven't done the math, but I will pretend like I know it. So like, as you can see, the number is a little inflated. I don't feel that these products are worth that amount. I feel like that's probably true. That's pretty much the case every single month, but I still love getting Birchboxes. I think they're fun to get, and when you get a good one and you get a product that you totally wanted, or you get a full-size one, it's always a treat. So I feel like sometimes maybe we get a little spoiled and we want a full-size every time. Let me know what you guys got in your Birchbox, even though that was very long ago. Yeah. Hopefully you got the Goop box if you wanted it. I didn't, oh well. So thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye.